As a teacher, you get hundreds of emails each and every week. How about we manage them better by applying some Inbox Zero techniques? Let's dive into it with another Flipped Classroom tutorial. Now, when we're talking about Inbox Zero, what we're really talking about is spending less time in our inbox. It's all about grouping your emails into various different groups and managing it better. Now, Gmail has a number of functions built into the platform that will enable us to really achieve higher productivity and effectively answer many more emails each and every day by spending just a fraction of the time we are spending right now. Let's jump into our Gmail. Now here you can see I have my Gmail open. This is a demo account and already there are some emails. Now I could either manually go through these emails and then respond to some and leave others unread because I know I have to action it, but that's one of the big pitfalls of using your inbox as a to-do list. If you're using your inbox as a to-do list, well then you're not using that time effectively because eventually you'll end up with hundreds of to-do items. Now here, the first thing we're going to do is have a look at what sort of emails we have. Now you can see we have a number of emails about students, reports, we have some advertising emails and newsletters. Well, we need to think about the different groups we're eventually going to be using. So what I'm going to be using is emails that I definitely have to respond to. So I have to take action and I have to action these emails. The second group will be an email where I'm waiting for a response. So let's say that I've sent an email to a colleague and I'm awaiting an answer from that colleague. That will be my second group. And then the third group will be emails that I want to keep for reference. In other words, say your duty timetable, or maybe it's an email that outlines the different classrooms that are being used that week. Well, we want to keep that email because it has some information we may refer to later during that week, or maybe even later in the month. Then we have a fourth group. This is the group of emails that we're going to archive. That means we don't have to see them, we don't want to look at them, but we also don't need direct access to them. And then finally, group five, these are emails that we know we'll never ever need again, and therefore we can delete those emails. So we have those five groups: action items where you need to take an action, waiting items where you're waiting for someone else to take an action, third one, just for reference, fourth, archived messages, and then finally, deleted messages we no longer want. Now let's make those groups by adding labels. First thing we're going to do is open up our settings, and we're going to click on See All Settings. Now in our settings, there is a Labels tab. So let's go ahead and open up that Labels tab and let's create those five labels. Now we know we want those five groups, and so we're going to create five labels. Here at the bottom, we have Create New Label. We're going to label the first one Action, Create. The second one Waiting, Create. The third item is the Notes. Fourth, archived, and then finally deleted. Now we're not creating the archived and deleted items, and I'll show you in a minute why that is. So right now we have waiting, notes, and action. Now because we've created the labels in our settings menu, you'll see they have now appeared on the left-hand side. So let's go ahead and color code these to make it easier for us to recognize the importance of these labels. So action items, let's go ahead and click on those three dots, give it a label color and choose red. They're important, I have to take an action. Notes, we can wait, let's make it blue. And then waiting, I'm awaiting someone else to action this. So let's go ahead and select orange. Now that we have these three labels, we can progress to the next step. And the next step is to stay in our settings menu, but to activate something that is really going to speed up our workflow. And I'll demonstrate that. Here in my inbox, what happens is when I open up this email, let's say that I finished this email, I've responded to it, and I'm ready to archive it. When I click on archive, I jump back to my inbox. Now, what you can do in Gmail is you can change the settings, you automatically jump to the next email. And that's what we're going to do now. So let's undo this, let's bring this email right back. I'm going to mark it as unread and jump into our settings. So let's open up our settings again, see all settings. And then we're going to go all the way to the right-hand side and we're going to enable Auto Advance. So here on the right-hand side under Advanced, we can Auto Advance enable this. Let's go ahead and enable Auto Advance and click on Save Settings. Now, because we've saved these, we need to go back into the settings to now use Auto Advance the way we want to use it. So let's go ahead and open up our settings, see all settings. and scroll down. Now, as you scroll down, you will notice that there is now a new option here, Auto Advance. Now, I'm going to select Auto Advance, and what do you want to do after archiving, deleting, muting, or anything you've done to that message? Go to the next newer conversation. You can also select older or a thread list. Now I'm going to select the next newer conversation. Okay, all done. Now the final step is for us to change the way our inbox looks. So at the moment we have a single inbox. What I want is I want to have those labels represented in my inbox. And so I want to spread it out a little bit and I want to have a visual of those different labels with an empty inbox on the left-hand side. Now at the moment you can see Gmail is said to have a primary, social, and promotional tab. I don't need those. I really want to use my labels. So let's jump back into our settings, click on See All Settings, and select Inbox. In our inbox, we're going to change the inbox type. Now the type we're using is going to be the multiple inbox. And here we can now set up 5 different inboxes. And we can use a special code for that. So let's have the first being our action item. So I'm going to type L colon, L as in label, L colon action, because that was the name of that label. And we're going to name this take action. The second one, L as in label colon, and then we're going to select the next one, which is waiting, waiting. And then we're going to type waiting for response. And then finally, L colon, and this will be notes, notes, and then information. There we go. Go ahead and scroll down. You can change the maximum page size. By default, it says 9. I'm going to make this 15 just to make it a little bit bigger. Where do you want your multiple inboxes to be? Now, as I said, I want them on the right-hand side. I want my main inbox on the left. So right of the inbox. We're going to scroll down. Do you want to have importance markers? Do you want Gmail to automatically apply those? No, I do not. So no markers and don't override filters, save changes. This is now going to change the settings, jump to my inbox. And as you can see here, I have my unread emails on the left-hand side. This is my inbox. On the right-hand side, I have those 3 labels and we can start actioning our emails. Let's go through our emails. I'm going to open up the first one. Hi, just adding you in here as it's an important meeting taking place I want you to be aware of. No need to attend, just be aware of this. So great, I don't have to take any action. I need to be aware of it, so I'm going to just quickly push that into my notes. At the top, I can go to my labels and I select notes. You can see that label has now been applied. I'm done with this email. Go ahead and archive it. Here's some information on the course you wanted to check out. Now here I am going to have to take action because I actually want to send my follow-up email about the course that I've then selected. So let's go ahead and add this to follow-up action items. There we go, action, and then apply this. You can see this now has a red action label. Now I'm going to jump back into my inbox to show you exactly what has happened to these emails. You can see that they're no longer on the left-hand side. And the reason for that is because every single time you've attached a label, what have I done? I've sent it to my archive. That means it's no longer showing up in my inbox. Say that in the future, I do still need access to them. I can always open up my more on the left-hand side and go to all mail. All mail includes all the archive messages as well. Now, back in our inbox, you can see I still have a number of messages to go through. And here on the right-hand side, I can open up Take Action because there is a single item in my Take Action. And we have that other email in the Information tab. Now, you can see I still have this one. I'm going to open this up again. Student 1 will be absent today. Okay, great. I know that. I've made a note of it. I no longer need this email. We don't even have to add it to a subgroup. So let's go ahead and delete this message. Delete, next one. Can you send me that report by Friday, please? Brilliant. I have to action this. Label it as action. And make sure you click on apply. That label has been applied. And this way you go through all your emails. Now I would suggest you go back maybe 1 month, 2 months, and then quickly go through all those emails, just adding those labels if you want to keep a message, otherwise archiving it. And if you definitely do not need the information in the email anymore, click on delete. Now we can speed this up even more. And how do we do that? Well, we do that by using shortcuts. Now, Gmail has built-in shortcuts. So let's go ahead and dive back into our settings. And we're going to go to See All Settings. But those shortcuts won't work until you've switched them on. So let's go ahead and scroll all the way down, and here you will see keyboard shortcuts. Now we're going to switch these keyboard shortcuts on. Now I love shortcuts, I use them all the time, and in Gmail, they will really speed up your workflow. Let's go ahead and save our changes and then go back to our inbox. Here, I can now jump into that message. Okay, I've already added to action. I can now archive the message. I'm going to type in the letter E to archive this message. And this jumps to the next one. Just checking in with the face to see how students are doing, transitioning back, anything you'd like to share. Now, I want to follow up on this. I actually do have something to share. So now, using my shortcuts, I'm going to really speed this up. So I'm going to type L for label, type action, enter. That label has been attached, and E for archive. Next one. And this is a way of really speeding through all your different emails. And here we come to a newsletter. Now, I love newsletters, they're incredibly helpful, but sometimes you have signed up to a newsletter that you are no longer interested in. So what is my suggestion there to really keep your inbox at zero? Scroll all the way down to the bottom of that letter and find that unsubscribe button. Unsubscribe from the newsletters you know you're no longer reading. However, if this is something that you are going to read and reference in the future, again, with the shortcuts L for labels, you can add it to whichever one you want, NO for notes, enter. That label has been applied, and E for archive. Now you can see my inbox zero in action. I have no new emails on the left-hand side. On the right, I have take action. You can see those three emails that I now have to follow up. We have waiting for response, nothing, and information. This is information I want to keep. Let's say that I have now finally sent my reports. Okay, I've sent that report. Everything is done. What I can do is now simply click on this X, remove that label, archive the message. In my inbox, no new emails. Under taking action, only two are left. Now let's say that I've already actioned it, I've archived it, and I now need access to that email. I've forgotten something, I need to check. Don't worry, all your emails, because you've archived them and you haven't deleted them, you can find them. You can either find them by going on the left to all mail, or you use Gmail's built-in search at the top. At the top, I can type in report, enter. This pulls up all the emails that reference report. Here is that archive message that used to be in my action inbox. Now it is in the archived inbox. Can you send me that report? I don't need it, so let's go ahead and jump back into our inbox. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, let me know in the comment section what's your favorite tip, what's your favorite feature, and how do you save time responding to all those emails that are coming in each and every day. Now, if you prefer a blog post where everything is written down with screenshots, there will be a link to my blog post on Inbox Zero in that description below. In the meantime, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.